7.5 WBLS, your number one source for R&B. Baby, it's time for us to step into the side of love tonight. Relax and unwind and just enjoy the essence of what we like to enjoy on a Monday night, Tuesday night, Wednesday night, or Thursday night. Doesn't matter. I'm Lenny Green. So nice to be with you back from the weekend. And as promised, I promised you that we would have company tonight. And if you go to WBLS.com and click on the Quiet Storm page, if you're online, the only thing to do is see us up close and personal. It is nice to welcome a dynamic singer, songwriter. And personally, I think this young lady is one of the most underrated singers that we have of our time. And, you know, she's really quiet. But when she decides to work, when she steps into the room to do her thing, she does it eloquently and to great lengths and great heights. It is nice to welcome Miss Martha Wash to the Quiet Storm tonight. How are you, Miss Wash?
I am doing fine, darling. How are you feeling?
I am doing well. Now that you have stepped into the building, I am doing well. For those of you who may be a little babe and you don't understand the history of this woman, can you share a little bit of your past with us tonight? Just a little bit.
How far back you want to
Well,
go?
I don't want to go back to the teenage. I don't want to go back to maybe you sang in church, you know, growing up. I don't want to go back that far. Let's just go back. Let's go back to Sylvester.
Okay.
Sylvester, another iconic figure that has unfortunately gone too soon. He left us too soon. But you and... at that time, you were working with another young lady, Izora.
Correct.
Were his backup singers.
Yes.
So you tell the story.
Okay.
Because I think I know a little bit about the story.
Well, I auditioned for Sylvester. And previous to me auditioning for him, I saw his show about 2 years earlier. Didn't know who he was. I had come to see Billy Preston because I was a huge Billy Preston fan.
Okay.
So I went over to the Berkeley Community Theater in Berkeley, California, and Sylvester was the opening act.
Wow.
And I just stood there. I didn't sit down. I just stood there watching him perform. And I said, oh, my God, who is this guy? He was great. I had just never seen anything like him before.
Okay.
His voice,
phenomenal.
Nothing.
Yeah.
You know, and... forgot about him. 2 years later, a few years later, I go and audition for him, not knowing that I was going to audition for him. Mm. I thought I was going to go and audition as a session singer or studio, you know, background work, and come to find out it was for him.
Wow.
So walked in there and told him who I was and told him I had seen his show those few years before opening for Billy Preston. At the time, he had two tall, white, blonde chicks who had just auditioned for him. And so they were still there.
Okay.
While I was there and I auditioned for him. So when he heard me, he told them they could leave.
Immediately, right?
Yeah.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you for coming. And he hired me. And asked if there was another woman that I knew that was as large as I was and that could sing. And I said, yeah. And I brought in Izora.
And she went from Sylvester to this cat and many, many more. We're going to understand. I'm going to try to bring you up to date. For those of you who are just, you know, a little bit too young, you may not understand the history of this woman, Miss Martha Wash. This song... is with Martha Wash and Luther Vandross. Now, yeah, here's the story. I fell in love with the song, not knowing. And Luther's the king of making remakes. I'm going through my mama's 45s.
Oh, yeah.
And I realized that this song was done by...
Benny King.
And I'm like, this is the song
Absolutely.
They did.
Oh, yeah.
So I want you to listen to it. It's a great song. And, man, just listen to the message of the song, but you're going to get overwhelmed vocally, obviously, because of Luther Vandross. And this dynamic woman, Miss Martha Wash. If you'd like to talk to Martha tonight, 212-545-1075. Like I said, you could see us up close and personal If you go online to WBLS.com and click on the Quiet Storm page, we're here for you. We'll be talking to you online in just a moment as well. I Who Have Nothing, classic, 107.5 WBLS. This is the Quiet Storm.
Thank you.
Welcome, welcome, welcome. Thank you for joining us online. If you're just tuning in, I'm sitting with one of the icons of R&B, one of the most underrated vocalists of our time, in my opinion, but dynamic. Miss Martha Wash is with us tonight in New York, and it's nice to have you in the building. I haven't had you in this building in quite some time.
Quite some time.
Quite some
yes.
time.
Yes.
And that's a shame because you do live in New York.
Yes, it is.
She stays so quiet. I don't understand. But you're really not quiet. You do a lot of shows from time to time.
I'm still working, despite what other people may think. I'm still working.
You know, and I know we have some folks watching us. What's the secret ingredient? I mean, you know, your career started, I guess, on a grand scale. Late 70s, obviously through the 80s.
Mm-hmm.
You did a lot of work. We're going to talk about the controversy because we just got to do that. But you managed to, by the grace of God, survive a lot of storms. And like you said, you are still working.
I'm still working. I was just in the UK last month. I was in Hong Kong late last year. So I'm still working.
That's a good thing.
Mm-hmm.
You have a brand new CD.
Yes.
Y'all been waiting for a minute. You're going to hear some of the songs in just a little while. And I understand this is on your label that you formed.
Yes, Purple Rose Records.
Tell us the direction and, you know, what can we expect from this brand new CD?
Not what folks may think.
And why is that?
Because it's not necessarily dance music. This is more adult contemporary.
Really?
Yeah. A little rock, a little pop.
So you took a whole new different direction.
Uh-huh.
For a reason?
Yes, it's time.
It's time to, show the diversity of what you can do?
Yes, I've always maintained, even down through the years, I've always maintained that I could do more than just one genre of music. Most people knew me by the dance music,
right?
Which is okay. But I am more than just that, and I can sing other types of music. And in my live shows, I do different styles of music. As opposed to just the dance.
Wow. So what can we expect on the brand new CD?
Well, I did a cover version of Aerosmith's Dream On.
Wow.
Which is a surprise for many people.
Why did you pick that one?
Because it kind of coincided with the theme of the CD, which is empowering, inspiring. Just do and be whatever you want to do and be.
You, in the late 90s, if I'm not mistaken, you did a cover of an Elton John song for a film.
I'm Still Standing?
Yeah.
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 That was First Wives Club.
First Wives Club. There you go.
Mm-hmm.
So taking classic songs and transforming them to the Martha Wash mode is not a hard thing for you to do.
No, not really. Not really. It just finding the right rhythms and the way you want to present it.
Rhythms, yeah. Does rhythms matter to you? Or because you transpose and...
Sometimes.
Okay.
Sometimes. Sometimes songs may not work at one particular rhythm as opposed to another one.
Mm-hmm.
It depends on, you know, how you want it or how best you think it may come out. Or sound, you know.
So by you taking a different approach than what your fan base is accustomed to hearing you,
mm-hmm.
For the most part, how do you think they will perceive your new music?
Well, so far the feedback that we've gotten has been very, very positive.
Right.
Very, very positive. So I'm very glad about that. And I always hope that my fans will just follow the journey that I'm on musically.
Yeah.
You know, and I believe that they have sense enough that they know that this is just something different for me and that it's good nonetheless, you know.
Mm-hmm. I want to go to one of the lines, if we can, Vito, if we can pull up, I think, line four and talk to somebody who might be holding on line four. Franny? Hello, Franny. Sorry for the wait. Say hello to Miss Martha Wash.
This is Jerry. What did you call me, Lenny?
Oh, I just got Franny on my paper, baby. I'm sorry, Jerry. How are you?
I'm good.
Sorry about that.
Thank you. This is Jerry Lynn from East New York, your homegirl.
Oh, that's my old neighborhood, too, East New York.
Yes, I know. And Miss Wash.
Yes, darling.
I'm so glad I got through.
Oh, thank you.
I mean, I loved you from way, way, way back when. I see you perform in Hilton Head in the late 90s.
Oh, my God.
Y'all was, you and the Weather Girl, y'all was singing It's Raining Men.
Mm-hmm.
So I had such a ball. I never enjoyed myself so much.
I'm glad.
I mean, you put on a show, and those men that you had with you, I had a ball. My girlfriends was laughing at me because I know your dancers was dancing to me.
So, wait. Obviously, I was not there. So talk about these dancers. I mean, what were these dancers doing?
Oh, they were dancing. It was Raining Men. They had no shirts on. They had little skinny little shorts
Martha.
On.
They had on shorts.
And they
were
dancing. Really, Martha? Muscle.
Of course.
Oh, God.
It was so
absolutely
enjoyable. I mean, that was one of my best weekends that I had.
Wow.
You know, and y'all, you was truly, truly good. I loved you then, and I still love you now, Miss Walsh.
Well, bless you. Thank you so much.
Well, you know what, Jerry, you'll be happy to know that she has a brand new CD that has just been released, so you may want to grab that as well. And can you tell her how she can get a hold of it?
Right. You can go to Amazon or iTunes.
Okay, and I will pick it up. I'm sure enough going to get it.
And we're going to give you a little...
Sing, girl.
She can sing. Sang.
Yeah,
she can
sing.
No question. Well, you know what? I'm going to give you a little taste of what she does so well off of the brand new CD in just a minute. So I want you to definitely listen. Okay,
Ben?
Thanks for calling tonight. Appreciate you.
All right. Thank you.
Martha Wash.
You keep doing your thing, Ms. Wash. Keep doing it.
I definitely will.
Thanks for joining us online tonight. Martha Wash is in our company tonight, and we will continue the conversation on air in just a little bit. I definitely want to get into, just again, for those who may not have followed your career, I think it's important that they understand why I say you're underrated, because, you know, you bring a lot, and that lady who just hung up is a true testament to what I'm saying. You bring a lot to the forefront when it comes to music. So when we get back on air in a couple of minutes, I do want to delve into you not getting credit when you gave your vocal talent to a couple of projects.
Mm-hmm.
And she was dissed. She was dissed. She was dissed visually. She was dissed written. they didn't put the name, her name, and they used someone else in her place. And you know the songs, and we'll share those songs. And this is nothing like secretive. It's been out in the news, but just in case you have not been aware of the legacy of Miss Martha Wash, when I say she has withstood the storms, you definitely have withstood storms, and you know what storming is all about.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And to be still surviving, it's a good thing these days, huh?
Okay. I'm still here.
Yes, you see? Still standing strong. Martha Wash with us. Join us on air. We're online, but join us on air right now, okay? WVLS, welcome inside the Quiet Storm. Joined tonight by a beautiful lady, a dear friend, the legendary Miss Martha Wash. And I hope you don't consider legendary to be a disrespect.
No.
she kind of dragged that out. Nah. No, it's just really out of respect because you definitely have a lot of lineage, to say the least, of being in this business for a while, being a survivor. There's many people that have come in and unfortunately haven't survived. There's
That's
many
true.
Groups
That's true.
that have come in and no longer. So you are definitely stood the test of time for a minute.
Well, you know, it's funny because I've always considered myself, as I've told other people, I just consider myself a working woman. This is what I do for my, you know, this is how I make my living.
But is it just work or is it love?
Well, I mean, the love is there as far as the fans and things are concerned. But even over the years, in years past, I've thought about getting out of the business a few times.
Wow.
Yeah, really. But I said, okay, I do that. Then what are you going to do? And as you can see, I'm still in the business.
Okay. So something that was naturally given to you, because it started at a very early age.
Yeah.
You can't, I don't think you can just walk away from it, because it's a God-given gift.
True. I knew that I would always sing. I just didn't know in what kind of genre it would be. Growing up, my mother wanted me to sing gospel only, and that was the only kind of music that was allowed in my house. So that's what I grew up listening to. But I've always liked all kinds of music.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, I need to go to the lines, but when we come back from the lines, I need to talk with you about how you were dissed in the industry. And I hate when they do that. And hopefully, you know, unfortunately, through your bad circumstance, hopefully they, you know, the executives, so-called, that may be left in the game of the music industry, learn that, you know, if someone is singing on a track, you give them full credit, visual credit and written credit. And you were not given that. But yet you were the voice behind great hits for CNC Music Factory and for Black Box. Yeah, everybody, Black Box. It wasn't the chick that you saw on the cover. It was Martha Wash. Now, let's keep it real. So I don't know what executive made that stupid decision. But anyway, let's go to the phones. Brother, say hello to Miss Martha Wash.
Martha Wash, how are you?
I'm doing fine, darling. How you feeling?
It's my pleasure. I met you. I was a neighbor for years of your partner, Azura.
Uh-huh.
And I used to live in Long Island.
Okay.
I used to cross the street from her.
Okay.
And I followed your career for years. You have one of the greatest versatile voices of all time.
Well, I appreciate that. Thank you so much.
And Lady Mash.
Lenny, if you get a chance, can you play a song for me by them?
Okay.
Don't take away my space.
Man.
Whoa.
Will that bring back a memory for you, Martha?
Yeah. Yeah, that was about the only song that they would play on that, for this kind of format, yeah.
Right,
used
right.
to do a lot of...
I play it.
Understandable, brother. Mm-hmm. All right, let's see if we can get that on for you tonight, man.
Thank you, and y'all have a blessed evening.
You too, thanks.
You know, before we pull up that song, I do want to delve into the brand new CD.
Mm-hmm.
I want to give everyone this musical treat. So this is a Quiet Storm exclusive, and I want you to bring yourself real close. Brand new music that Martha has been working on. How long have you been working on this project?
Oh, about a year and a half.
Okay. I want to go to It's My Time.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me about the song.
It's My Time was written by a lady by the name of Helena Johansson, a Swedish songwriter.
Really?
Came from Sweden into Nashville. Seriously. She's a singer-songwriter, and we heard this song, and we said, I like it.
Let's see if you like it. Martha Wash, new music, baby, Inside the Quiet Storm, 107.5 WBLS.
I can see it clear. I'm getting close. I'm almost there. It's indescribable. It's my time to shine. It's my time. We all have dreams. We all have goals. With laughter and tears, that's what we're living for. It's my time to shine. It's my time. indescribable. It's my
time. 107.5 WBLS. That's something brand new from Martha Wash. It is your time. It has been your time, and it ain't stopping no time soon.
No.
And that's a good thing, I would think, right?
Yes, it is. I got to keep it moving. I got to keep doing it.
Well, I would hope so. You know, your time of celebrating. If I'm not mistaken, did I read last year that you celebrated? It's Raining Men.
Mm-hmm, 30 years old.
30 years. You did this interesting thing on David Letterman.
Okay, call it interesting. There you go.
I got it. After the call that we just had online, and the lady said that, you know, when it's Raining Men, she saw you, I think, and when you were with, you know, Izora.
And the dances and stuff. And yeah, they were half naked.
The men came out half naked.
That. Mm-hmm. Yes, that's right.
And you still do this.
No.
You modify?
Every now and then, depending on where I am, they may have dances that they'd like to use for the song in particular, It's Raining Men. And I'll do it like that. Yes.
You have been a true soldier in this industry. I just want to know, with all the controversy that you have been through, could that be some of the reasons why you may have thought about or entertained your mind for a small moment of you leaving the industry because of how you were treated when the misconception happened with the CNC Music Factory and Black Box?
Yes and no. It wasn't the full reason of trying to, you know, leave the business. I think at that point I had gotten to a point where I wasn't signed with the record label. I wasn't putting any music out. And I just felt like things weren't happening for me, you know. And I'm saying, why am I still beating my head up against the wall? I'm kind of tired. Do I really, really want to continue doing this? Mm-hmm. I think was basically what it was. And I felt at that time, no. But then again, I'm saying to myself, okay, you're saying no, but what are you going to do?
Exactly.
And I just stayed with it.
I'm glad you did. And I know I'm not speaking by myself on that note. Martha Wash, we're gonna retain her, hold her hostage for a little while longer. I'm gonna pick your brain on our topic of conversation. You know, you heard it. It's gonna be a pretty interesting topic for Confessions of Love, and we're also gonna get a chance to just hear maybe a song or two from the brand new CD as well. So we got her. Martha Wash, Inside the Quiet Storm, 107.5 WBLS.
Thank you.
you know any of the other songs that you want to hear?
It was, I don't know, it was track six. Oh. 107.5 WBLS. We are online and talking to you, and I thank you for watching all across the country and all around the world as well. I want to thank my friends from Spain, from Germany for logging on tonight. Appreciate the love in a great way. You have an international based audience of fans following you.
Love Spain.
I've never been there.
Oh, really? Honey, I was in Barcelona last year. You got to go.
How is it?
I love Spain.
Really? What is it about Spain that you love so much?
The people.
Really?
The men. Yes,
yes. Was it raining men over there for you as well?
Yeah, and it rained the day after I got there. I was supposed to be doing a show there.
It rained. It really rained.
It rained for 2 days straight, which is something that doesn't happen in Barcelona.
So you brought the thunder.
Yes. Yes.
So Martha, wow, you must have an understanding mate. How is your love life, Martha? Hey. What's going on?
Well, how's yours?
Well, no, I asked you first. This is my interview, Martha. When I come on your show, we can flip the script.
How's yours? Tell me
about
yours.
No, I want to know about yours. See, I'm interviewing you, Martha.
You want to sit down
and people
want to
know. No,
it.
People want to know. What's up with Martha? You know, what's going on? So, no one would think I would ask the question. But, you know, we have to ask the question from time to time. So
you have to.
Because people want to know. You know, because like I said, you stay
the
very laid back.
Inquiring minds
want to know. So, how's your love life?
The love life is okay right now.
Okay.
I'm by myself right now, so it's okay.
It's not raining men?
Not at the moment, no.
It's always raining men for you. What are you talking?
Hey. No. No? Not all the time.
I think I was watching her blush, you know. I've never seen you get, like, you know, red feet before.
Yeah, okay.
You got red feet tonight, though, huh? Mm-hmm. Wow. Mm-hmm. I see the pressure. I see the pressure moment.
Okay.
So, you know, we have a very interesting topic going on tonight. I want to know your thoughts on it. And I've noticed, you know, just being in regular relationships, how certain things happen. And what I mean by that is when I get into a relationship and I find that women that I may have wanted to talk to before, now everybody wants to pay me every mile. Now that I've committed myself to one person, mm-hmm. you know, now women want to come out and, hey, Lenny, what's up? Da, da, da. Where were you like a year ago? Where were you like 8 months ago? How about 4 weeks ago before I committed to this relationship? So it's something that you ladies do. And I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's something that we have an aura about, but maybe you can help, you know, break it down for me.
I don't think it's women in, I think that role could be either way.
Really?
Yeah.
So that happens to women too, huh?
Sure.
I never knew that.
Yes.
So what is it, do you think? What is it so attracting to the person? That must be your phone.
No,
that is my phone.
See, you talk about me here. Okay.
Hold on, I'm going to fix mine real quick. Can you do that? I fixed mine. So what do you think is the aura that we exude that would make people come to us knowing, I mean, they may not know we're in a committed relationship, but what is it that we have that we didn't have 2 weeks before then?
Was it 5 minutes ago?
Yeah. Like, I mean, did something change?
No. I think it could be that kind of like, for some people, it could be that forbidden thing. You know?
Something that someone else has? Or
exactly.
I know I shouldn't have it, but I'm wanting it anyway?
All of the above.
That's crazy.
Yeah, all of the above.
That's crazy.
That's how some people think. I mean, look. That's just what it is. It can be all of the above. Everything that you just said. Some may want to do it just on. They know it's wrong. They see the situation, but they just want to do it. Oh, I'm just going to do it just for the hell of it.
Yeah, and that's I don't get. I really don't get. So I like for you to call in tonight if you like, so we can engage a little bit more in depth in conversation about this. We're directing it to you, ladies, but it can go either way, as Martha just indicated. So why is a man or woman more attractive once they fall into a relationship? Can somebody answer that million-dollar question? If you know they're, if I know someone is in a relationship, I really don't want to be bothered with them.
Okay, that's you.
I know. And we can have more clones like me. I think we have a better situation. You know, we have less infidelity. I mean, come on. You don't agree?
Well, no.
She has a brand new CD out. And it's called Something Good. Now, something good to you might be finding that person in a relationship, and you figure that you don't have to, you know, go too far out of your way. You just need them to take care of your maybe financial needs or whatever beneficial aspects that you might need at that particular moment. So something might be good for you in that, but Something Good is the name of Martha's brand new CD. Something Good. Long awaited. And I'm sure this is going to be not the last one you do.
Not right? Another, what, 15, 17 years?
Yeah, not. I mean, you yeah, come on, you got to do that.
I know.
Well, and will you ever consider doing an album that Mama always wanted you to do to begin with, and that's gospel?
Oh, sure. I had actually started working on the gospel album a few years ago.
Oh, wow.
And just kind of put it to the side.
Okay.
But yes, definitely.
I could see that. Definitely. I can see that. That would be phenomenal.
That's my foundation.
And that would show the diversity too, because, well, you haven't recorded any gospel, did you? To release.
Actually, I recorded with a song with a friend of mine, Bishop Yvette Flunder, and the Fellowship Choir. I recorded a song called "He'll Understand and Say Well Done," which is a old gospel song.
Fellowship Choir of New York?
No, of San Francisco.
Okay.
But you can find that on iTunes as well. But yeah, I've done gospel recordings.
That would be a good thing. Yeah. And we still need you to do one more other. I see I have two albums. I'm trying to keep her. Well, I'm just making sure that you don't have no more notions of like, should I still stick around? Should I still do singing? I think you need to do a Christmas album.
Yeah.
And that lasts, right? Am I right, Ruth?
That's been talked about too. That's been talked about too, yeah.
And I wasn't even a part of the meetings.
No, you weren't, but that has been talked about as well.
Great minds think alike. And if you think that, if you suggest any particular album Martha Wash should do, you need to hit her up on Twitter, Martha_Wash.
Somebody wanted a jazz one.
Oh, that would be hot too.
Jazz and blues.
Yeah. I could see that too. Yeah. So we got three albums coming from you. We're going to have the gospel.
Busy.
Yeah, you're going to be busy.
I'll be real busy.
That's a good thing.
Okay.
And we'll have you back in the seat talking about your love life. We won't grill you too much. Not too much. In parting, I just want to obviously just say thank you for you taking out your time to come in. It's been a mighty long time since we sat down and talked. And I'm not going to, you know, I'm not going to go back, because I go back way before New York with radio. When Izora was alive, and y'all were beautiful spirited ladies, and you still are a great lady. You know, you're a great lady, wonderful personality, and all the true accolades that you need to receive truly must come your way, and I'm sure they will continue to pour in like no tomorrow.
No, well, I appreciate that, and I just appreciate all the fans that have stuck by me all these many, many years.
Yeah.
My ups and downs, but hey, we're all still here. That's the biggest blessing.
That is the biggest blessing. And you know what? We should also mention that you are well-respected in the gay community, probably because it's Raining Men.
Well, even before that,
really?
I would have to say all the way back to Sylvester.
Yeah.
And it's just continued over the years.
I got the feeling. Yeah. You're right. Because strong dance music, and that has definitely taken you well over the years, and it will continue. So, will you ever go back to doing a couple of more dance songs? Because if so, then that's another album right there. So we're up to like four albums. I'm thinking four albums
you
right
know,
now.
You're four, really five. Asking a lot.
But okay. You know what? She won't be saying that once that money kind of starts keep coming in, though. She'd be like, he was asking a lot, but you know what? I'm glad he did, because look what's going on. So you can't blame me for, you know.
I know we haven't seen each other in quite a long time, but honey, hey, you getting all your numbers in now.
I'm trying to help the foundation of Martha Wash. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to make sure that you've covered every genre. You just said you love doing other stuff, right?
I do.
So we need that gospel. We need that Christmas. Yes, you mentioned jazz and blues. And now we got to dance. So that's four albums you can expect from Martha Wash over the next 4 years. That's right. You're going to have to do one a year. That's not asking too much, is it?
Real busy.
You're going to be real busy. Uh-huh. You know, that's right. You know what? If you feel that bad, you can cut me off 10%. I know it's cutting into your manager's pocket, but I came up with the ideas too. So I wasn't even at the meeting, you know? So y'all didn't even invite me to the meeting to say, Lenny, what should Martha do from this point? I had to think of all this myself. Okay. You gave me one. You want me to cut it down to 5%? No problem. No.
We'll talk about negotiations.
Look, I'm not asking for it. I should be doing the interlude on one of the songs, but I'm not going to reach that far.
You know what? That may be something you could do.
I could do that.
You could do that. Yes.
I can't do it in the gospel. That's a little too deep. I don't want to go.
No.
Okay.
Look, you're right. The kind of music that's coming out of gospel right now, you'd fit right up in there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Then if that's the case, then that's the deal. Yeah. You know what? You might have. I'll have my people call you.
Please do.
And we can work it out. Martha Wash, we're going to go on air with her, but thank you for joining us online. And like I said, it really pays off to watch and listen online, because this is what you get, what you can't get on air all the time. But make sure you get the brand new CD, Something Good. It's available and for you now on iTunes and Amazon. All right? WBLS. It's the Quiet Storm. Time for Confessions of Love. And I've held her hostage for just a little bit, and that's Miss Martha Wash. And thank you so much for being willing to confine to my studio today. I appreciate that. If you were watching and listening online, then you know I was trying to grill her about her personal life and find out if, you know, she was in love. You care to share it with the millions of people that are, I guess she's quiet. Don't get quiet on me now. Should we let it out the back that you're going to be, no, you're not going to jump the broom.
Oh, no.
Not yet.
No, not yet.
Not yet.
No,
but you will let us know.
I am single.
Single and mingling.
Mm-hmm.
Do you date?
You have somebody in mind?
Well, I guess we need to talk.
Can we call them?
Yeah. What, you going to do an interview?
Well, no.
Okay.
Hey, I'm here.
Yes, you are. I'll have to think about that. Okay.
Here you go.
The topic tonight, this is the time of night, Martha, where we delve into interesting topics. And tonight's topic, as we just learned online, talking to Martha Wash, she has a very interesting, you know, perspective, because we just kind of labeled the question one way, but it could go to both man or woman. So why is it a man or woman more attractive when he or she is in a relationship? And your answer to that question is because of what?
It could be for various reasons. I think I told you earlier, one can be for just on GP, just to mess with people. They may not even really want them, but see how the relationship looks, and say, I want to mess with this a little bit.
Okay.
You know?
Wow.
That's how some people think now.
I got a young lady on the line. Want to get her thoughts. Let's see. Salima, what would you say to this question?
Men in relationships, they're always looking for like a good time, but they're not gonna leave their wife. They just want, somehow home is boring. Like, they go home, they do the same old thing day and night, every day, and they're always looking to go out and have a good time. Maybe they would cheat, but they're not leaving their wife.
But are they appealing to you as a single woman?
No, I don't like men that have wives. They're not appealing, because I know what they want. And I know that's all they could offer you. So no way. It's a turnoff.
Thank you so much, Salima. 212-545-1075. Why is it a man or woman is more attractive to you when he or she is in a relationship? Martha Wash is with us tonight. Give us a call on the Love Lines and let's talk about it inside of Confessions of Love. Why is it a man or woman more attractive when he or she is in a relationship? We're going to hear some more music from Martha Wash in just a few minutes. So I want you to stay very, very close to me. In the meantime, let's go back for a minute and reminisce with Miss Erica Badu. The Quiet Storm. 107.5 WBLS, baby.
Tell him right, he thinks I'm right.